We write devices, mnemonic, so the professors won't think you're moronic. Learn Simmer songs and you'll do us proud, singing tunes while taking tests, but not out loud.
High five for Simmer Song 5! The topic of this video is the...
I know.
What?
The heart.
How do you know that, Dr. Simmerline?
Check out his cool tie. It's got heart.
So let's get pumping. When you look at an anatomy atlas, you've probably noticed that blood vessels are either colored red or blue. Usually arteries are red and veins are blue. The color represents the oxygen content of those vessels. But if you've looked a little bit closer, you probably noticed that some of the great vessels at the base of the heart seem to be colored the wrong color. Why is this? Well, when blood returns from the systemic circulation, it has just dropped its oxygen off to the body's cells, and therefore is deoxygenated and colored blue, as we see the superior and inferior vena cava are colored on our model. The blood returns from the systemic circulation through those vessels, passes through the right side of the heart, and leaves via the pulmonary trunk and the pulmonary arteries, but still blue because it hasn't gotten to the lungs yet. Once it does get into the lungs, then it changes from blue to red because it's become oxygenated. That oxygenated blood then leaves the lungs via four pulmonary veins, which return to the left side of the heart into the left atrium. Passes through the left side of the heart, out through the aortic arch, which would be red just as we... Oh, where's the aortic arch? Oh! You're breaking my heart.
Let me do a little heart surgery.
Are you licensed for this?
Don't worry. I'm a real doctor.
And good as new. And colored red because oxygenated blood is found in the aortic arch. So remember, arteries carry blood away from the heart. Arteries away, AA, and veins carry blood toward the heart. Another thing that could be a little bit tricky are the heart valves. There are four heart valves. We have two semilunar valves and two atrioventricular valves. The atrioventricular valves have some alternate names that might be a little hard to remember, but we have a mnemonic that makes it a breeze. On the right side of the heart, we have the right atrioventricular valve. Its other name is the tricuspid valve because it has three cusps, like most of the valves in the heart would have. So if you can remember, right atrioventricular tricuspid, R-A-T, that spells rat. So you have a rat on the right side of your heart. On the left side of your heart, we have the left atrioventricular valve. The left atrioventricular valve has two alternate names. One is the mitral valve. Mitral because it kind of looks like the hat a bishop would wear, which is called a mitre. Also, the other name is the bicuspid valve because it has two cusps, rather than three like all of the rest of the valves would have in the heart. So if you can remember, left atrioventricular mitral bicuspid, L-A-M-B, you'll remember you have a lamb on the left side of your heart. So again, on the right side of the heart, a rat. On the left side of the heart, a lamb. So today's song is going to be one that was used to rally the troops during World War II, and a lot of the topics that we've been talking about will be incorporated in those lyrics. The title of that song is
Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy.
So enjoy and sing with us now.
To be in a cave, you bring the blood back to your heart. Right atrium is where the pumping gets its start. Straight through the right atrioventricular valve.
Rat!
Tricuspid's its other name. The two are one and the same. Contraction atrial fills the right ventricle with its EDV. And now it's free to start systole. The pressure closes AV valves as heart sound one. Then opens semilunar valves so blood can run into the pulmonary trunk.
And then the pressure goes down, thou shut a second heart sound. Duh. Your lungs, this blue blood flows, where it can then dispose of its CO2, get O2 new and turn red from blue. Body.